What? Do you want me to go out again?
This is amazing. As horrible as this may seem, real human bones were used to create and decorate the ship. The way the bones are connected is also rather interesting. They are fused together by an unknown method, somehow using gold in the process. Besides, we haven't yet examined the ship's hold and the source of the mysterious light inside. The layer of ice covering the ship is too thick and impossible to break. The ship is spreading the cold. Let's hope this ice will melt here, inside the museum walls.
Thank you. My name is Stephen Cooper. I study paranormal activity, and I came to Erlenbourg to investigate the Ship of Bones. Listen, we had a deal with one man. He should have sold me the secret information about it, but his soul was stolen, just like the other souls. Now his skeleton with the bat is hanging around nearby, and I still need the docs. If you bring them to me, I'll give you something that will calm down the skeleton.
a respected raven with a science degree, not a carrier pigeon.
Father.
The ship did have gold in it, and the members of the expedition that found the ship felt they deserved a reward. But Harold Dowson was so anxious to declare his love, he couldn't wait and decided to borrow from an old friend. He should not have mentioned the gold. Wanting only the best, Harold chose the most expensive and beautiful ring he could find, and then headed to the museum to declare his love for Kate. But it was too late. Only a few steps from the shop, the spreading ice overtook Harold and covered the entire city. Skeletons hit the ground, the ice draining the life out of the inhabitants and Harold. child sweetheart, Kate, was present when the thieves stormed the museum looking for gold. She tried to stop them, to no avail. The ancient powers woke from the ship's depths. The ice on the ship started cracking. A cold glowing came from the ship and enveloped the brave girl. Hel, the ruler of the dead, took Kate's body for her own. In her new human form, she rained down her might on the bewildered thieves, taking their souls.